Hello everyone, now I will tell you about all the functions of this add-on and how you can use it. I specifically made a couple more common mistakes here, because of which the automatic rename button will not identify objects. And I'll show you how the fix buttons work. Click on the automatic renaming button so that we notice that there are several objects left here. Let's see what these objects are. Let's skip that for now. So let's consider the cases in which you use the fix origin. One object has its origin here and the other here. You select one object using the Shift key. You select the second object that you think is correct in order for it to be active, then click the OU fix. After that, both sources are placed in the same place. Now these two objects will be defined by add-on here, he has placed them in collections. Here is the second case where your objects are moving. To fix this, you select one object, and then the object that you make active and click the Fix Position button. This will happen if you have not reset the starting point, but simply moved the objects from their place. The last object is this one. Look, they differ significantly from each other in size. This object has a larger size, and this one is smaller. When this condition is met, the size of the objects is checked. That is, if they have any small discrepancies, it's not scary. But if they have such huge discrepancies, he will not determine them. Therefore, at such moments it is necessary to disable the scale control, so I'll put them together. And now he's put them on the shelves. And also about the scale control. I will delete these collections now. To do this, you have the P button, it removes all suffixes. I recommend in terms of scale. Start with 2 for a more precise definition of objects. The larger the number specified here, the more accurate the size check will be. Then, by reducing this number, you will be able to create softer frames for checking the state by size. Then you will only have the object on which you need to completely disable the conditions or other errors will occur. When you click on the auto rename button, you don't need to highlight anything. So I'll show you something else. So, we'll erase everything. Look, there's a rename button low high. If you don't want to fix bugs and use the zoom controls needed for automatic renaming, you can rename two objects separately. So I'll show you how to start without the auto button. Select one object first, and then the second. They renamed themselves, and Don himself automatically determined which of them was low and which was high. Then, using the auto button, a collection is automatically created and they are distributed among collections. Without the auto checkbox, you click on the collection button. That is, here they fit into the collection. With the auto button, everything will happen automatically. Select this object and rename it with one click to add it to the collection. I also wanted to show there is an export of FB and there is an export of FB select. If you don't need to export the whole model, then you can use the function in BigSelect export. To do this, you can simply click on the two objects they need to be named and click on the button in BigSelect export. Here you have two files in Bix. Then you press the open monkey button and it starts. Now add these two files. Here you have this detail. Look, you can roll it up. For example, we had another detail here, you can choose it. And that's it, too. Select both of them and click export in format to Big Select. Just expand the MormoZ program and it will automatically update. Here, that is, here. You can also call this one. And, for example, it was highlighted and exported in BigSelect format. And you have a button in BigSelect that creates files in Bix from all objects in collections. So, we perform automatic renaming and export of all files to Bix here, and you have the whole model in MormoZ format. If this button does not work for you, it means that you have not specified the path to MormoZ. Specify the path and everything will work for you. This automatic collection button works for both this button and this one. If you click on the automatic naming button without it, it will simply rename all objects, but will not put them in collections. And after that, to put them in collections, click Collection. You also have buttons, as well as a delete suffixes button that you already know. It removes all suffixes with underscores. This button adds the suffix low and this is high. It's pretty simple, you can do it quickly, just automatically. Well, that's it. If you liked it, don't subscribe. The development of this project depends on your support. Thank you all for watching, have a nice day.